So roll the shoulders back and down. Close your eyes. Just bring your awareness to your breath. Take a big deep breath in through the nose. And then whatever's going on for you this morning, as you exhale, just let it go. Again, a big deep breath in through the nose. And as you exhale, let it go. One more big deep in breath. And let it go. Just slowly fluttering open the eyes. Bring the awareness back into the room. Just take hold of your right hand or right wrist with your left hand. Take it up and over the head and really reach, pull, lengthen, breathe. Inhaling. And exhaling. And let it go. Other side, left arm lifts, hold on, pull the belly in. Breathing, opening, inhale. And exhale. And let go. Pull those knees in towards you, hug the knees in, find the breath. And gently roll onto all fours. Take your knees nice and wide. Take the big toes to touch. Sit back onto your heels. Extend your arms. And we find that lovely child's pose. Take both of your hands over to the left side of the mat. Place the right hand on top of the left. Take the forehead to the floor. And find that breath. Inhaling and exhaling. Bring it back to center. Walk the right hand over, take the left hand on top of the right hand, and take your head again down to the floor. Bring yourself back to center and just hold in your child's pose for a few breaths. Inhaling and exhaling. Come all the way up. Take your knees below your hips, the palms below your shoulders. I'm just going to bring some movement into the body. So maybe like a wave, just rolling forwards and backwards, arching, rolling, coming into your palms, into your heels. Just find how your body wants to move this morning. Maybe you have stiffness in your back and you want to wiggle from one side to the other. And come back to center. Starting with our cat and our cow, our palms are below the shoulders, the knees are below the hips. Inhale, we lift the chest, we look up and we lengthen. And as we exhale, we tilt, we pull our pelvis under, tuck the tailbone under, look towards the navel and press into those palms. Inhale, we lift, we lengthen, we roll open into that cow. Exhale, we pull under and we take our angry cat. One more inhaling, really find that diaphragmatic breath, let your belly be full of air. And send it back. Find neutral. I'm going to swivel around so you can see me, but send your right leg out and away from you. Your left palm stays flat on the floor, and we send the right arm up towards the sky. Opening here, breathing here. Bring that right arm in, and we're going to send the right arm under and through our left. Inhale, we open, lengthen slowly. Exhale, we send it through. Inhaling, we lengthen, open, breathe. Exhale, we send it through. And then we bring the hands down to the floor. And it might be that you only move back a couple of inches. It might be that you can go all the way back onto the heel. Bring the head down. Come back up. Other side, we bring that right leg in. Send our left leg out. Pull the belly and lift the chest. Send that left arm up. Opening the chest, trying to stack the shoulders one on top of the other. Exhale, send it through. Again, inhale, we open, we lift, we push down through the outside of our left foot. Exhale, we send it through. One more, inhale, we lift, we lengthen, we open. Exhale, we bring it down. And again, it might be a little bend. It might be that you can sit all the way back onto the heel. Take the forehead down. And come back up. Just resetting yourself. Take your knees together, your toes together. Take the forehead to the mat. And find that child's pose. Taking a big deep breath in. Welcome if you've just joined us on Insta Live. And out. One more in your child's pose, breathing in and breathing out. And then from child's pose, we're going to lift all the way up and take our downward facing dog. Pad it through your heels. Again, just check in with your body this morning. How are you feeling? Have you got any tension through the back of your legs? Then bring your right knee forwards, and we're going to take the knee in between our wrists. Send the left leg out and behind us. Come onto the fingertips. Walk your right foot to the outside of your left hand and find that lovely high pigeon. Nice. So those of you on Zoom, can you look up and lift your chest a little bit? Wonderful. Great stuff. And if you're with me on Insta, just make sure that you're dropping your hips down to the floor. Feel that right glute start to open. Press the palms back to the floor. And we're going to come from our restorative pigeon into a flying pigeon. So tuck your left toes under and we squeeze that right knee in. Holding here for 3, 2, 1, flip the right foot in between the hands, take the left knee down, untuck the toes. We send the arms all the way up towards the sky, finding lift here, finding length here. Opening. Relax your faces, breathing. And then take your hands behind you, interlace through your fingers, push your hands away. You're tight in your shoulders, bringing your hands off your glutes can be a little feat. So just see if you can push your hands down and open the chest even more. Your knee wants to stay over your ankle. Breathing. And then release those hands. Take the hands down again to frame that right foot. We're going to tuck the left toes under, come back through flying pigeon by flipping that foot and squeezing it in. Hold for 3, 2, 1. Take it to the back and find down dog. Lift the hips nice and high, pad through those heels. Breathing here. We come straight into the other side. So we lift our left leg, bend the left knee, bring the left knee forward in between our wrists. Take the right leg down, untuck the toes. Take the left foot over to the right side, come onto the fingertips, lift the chest, and again we open here. This is such a satisfying stretch. Making sure you're pushing your right hip. So you've got these bony bits, your frontal hip bones. They should be going down towards the floor, not out to the side, down towards the mat. So you're dropping that right hip down. Pull the belly in. Maybe come high on your fingertips. Looking good on Zoom? Nice. I hope you're still with me, those on Insta. Bring the palms down. Tuck the right toes under. Again, we're gonna find that flying pigeon. Squeeze it in, really push through those palms. Inhale and exhale, flip the left foot. Take the right knee down, untuck the toes, pull the belly in, inhale, we lift. We open here. We send the hands down behind us, interlace through the fingers, push the hands down. And again, just open through the chest. Breathing here. Inhaling and exhaling. And then release those hands. We're gonna flip through, tuck your right toes under, push through your right heel, bring that foot through. Hold and flying pigeon for 3, 2, 1, down dog. Pad through the heels. Take the feet down to the floor one by one. And then come onto your knees and sink into child's pose. And just staying in your child's pose for a few more breaths. Inhaling. And exhaling. Just readjusting. Inhaling. And exhaling. From child's pose, we lift back into down dog. We walk our feet forwards and hang in a forward fold. Make sure your feet are hip width apart, your knees are bent, your left fingertips are down on the floor. We bend through the left knee, straighten the right leg, and send the right arm up to the sky. Big breath in and out. In and out. Bring the right hand down. Pull the belly in. We're then going to send our left arm up, bend the right knee, straighten the left leg, and open here. Inhale and exhale. Bring it back to center. Find that forward fold, maybe take hold of your elbows, and we just rock from one side to the other side. Release the hands to the floor. Inhale, we find that halfway lift, flat back, look forwards. Exhale, we take it down. And then inhale, we roll all the way up. And now I'm going to chop my head off on two, but we're going to lift up. And we're slowly going to come all the way back down to the floor. Take the fingertips onto the mat. Try and straighten your leg. If you can take the palms down to the floor, then do. I'm going to stay with fingertips and look forward. Start to walk your hands out and away from you. And then your feet back. And we come back into down dog. Lifting those hips up nice and high. Pad through the heels. Pull the belly in. And send the right leg up to the sky. Bend the right knee. Bring the right foot forward. Place it in between the hands. Take the left knee down. Untuck the toes. And nice and gently we lift all the way up into that low lunge. Make sure that your right knee is going over your ankle. Left hand comes to the outside of your right hip. We look towards our right fingertips. Inhaling. And exhaling. Send that left arm out long. Take the left hand down to the floor. The right arm comes up to the sky. Inhale. And exhale, tuck the left toes under, push into a higher variation of this lunge, inhaling. And exhaling, bring the right hand down, come into high lunge, lift it up, breathe it in, breathe it out, and then take the hands all the way down to frame the front right foot, take the front foot to the back, find your plank, lower the knees down, first one of the day, potentially, untuck your toes. We bend the elbows and we hover to the floor. Inhaling, little baby cobra, little lift. Tuck the toes under, exhaling, find down dog. Other side, we lift the left leg. We bend the left knee. We bring the left foot forward in between the hands. We pull the belly in. We send the arms all the way up to the sky. We make sure that the knee is over the ankle. The right hand comes to the outside of your left leg. The left hand goes back. Breathing in and out. Send the right arm forwards. Breathe it in. Breathe it out. Take the right hand down to the floor. The left arm up to the sky. Breathe it in. And breathe it out. Tuck the right toes under, lift into that high lunge. And then bring the arms up, take it all the way into the full position. Take the hands down towards the floor, take the front foot to the back, find your plank, maybe lower the knees if you want to, pull the belly in, and we hover to the floor. Inhaling up dog, exhaling down dog. Padding it through the heels. Big breath in and out. Big breath in and out. Again, we lift the right leg up towards the sky. We bend the knee. We bring the right foot forward. Take it in between the hands. Pull the belly in, lower the left knee down. Inhale, we rise. Keep the toes tucked under at this stage. Can we come straight into high lunge? Can we bring the hands to prayer? Can we sink in even deeper into that right knee and take your left elbow over your right knee and lift the right elbow, woo, try not to wobble like me, up towards the sky. I'm really wobbly. So this is where we find the breath and we try and calm the body, find that focus. There you go, you got it too. Inhaling, bring the palms into the center of the chest and push back strong through that left heel. Inhale and exhale. Bring the hands all the way down to the floor. We're going to find that flying pigeon again. We're going to pull the leg in, squeezing it in. Push through the palms. Hold. Take it back to plank. And we hover to the floor. Inhaling, upward facing dog. Lift the chest. Exhale, child's pose. Hold for a breath. Hold for a moment. Big deep breath in and out. And we're going to do all of that on the left hand side. So pushing back into your downward facing dog. Padding it through the heels. Take the left leg up towards the sky. Bend the knee, bring the left foot forward, take it in between the hands. Take the right knee down, pull the belly in, send the arms up. Tuck your right toes under, and we're gonna lift into that lunge. Bring the palms together, And then we take our right elbow over our left knee. Lift. Can you bring your palms in between or in between your clavicles or in your chest? Push back strong through your right heel. Open here. Breathing in and out. Breathing in and out. Bring the hands all the way down to the floor. Again, we're finding that flying pigeon. We're squeezing that left foot in. Hold, squeeze, lengthen. Take it back. Find your plank. Lower the knees if you want to. Untuck the toes. And we hover the floor. Hover down to the floor. Inhaling. Up dog, lift the chest. Exhaling, child's pose. Finding that lovely softness. Breathing in and out. And then gently coming up. So we're going to keep it slow but strong. We're going to come into the prep for crow. So if you're in the living room or in a space, please make sure that you don't have any sharp edges around you. We're going to take the palms down towards the floor, come onto the balls of our feet and sit back towards our heels. Your knees want to then go out wide. Your elbows want to come inside your knees and your knees are pushing onto the back of your elbows. And today we're just going to play, unless you know or have crow in your practice, we're just going to play with lifting our feet off the floor to find a little bit of air time, that sweet spot. So push the palms in towards the mat, squeeze the elbows out, the knees in, and just play with lifting one foot, then maybe the other foot off the floor. So again, palms are down on the floor. You're squeezing your elbows into the inside of the knees, knees onto the outside of your elbows or triceps. You're pulling your tailbone in or up, sorry, lifting the tailbone up and taking the weight into the palms until you can find that sweet spot where you could lift one, maybe two, maybe both of your feet up and off the floor. Just have a play one more time. See if you can get a little bit more air time. Nice, Juliet. Breathing. Good, Mark. Inhaling and exhaling. And then come into your child's pose. Take your head down to the floor. Let the body relax. Big inhale. And exhale. Take the palms back flat to the floor. Tuck the tailbone under, pull the belly in, and we're going to sink it back towards our heels. Look towards your hands. Your palms are nice and wide. We're going to see if we can hop or bunny hop our feet forward in between our hands and hang in a forward fold. Just let the head be heavy, the neck be long. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, look forwards. Exhale, we take it down. And again, we're going to step back long with our right leg. We're going to find that lunge position. Bring your palms together. And again, if you want to, find breath. Sink deep into that left leg. Inhale. And exhale. And then release the left hand down inside your left foot. Take the right foot flat to the floor. And we're going to send the right arm up to the sky. If you want to, if you've got a block, maybe Monopoly if you're in your living room, maybe a cushion, you can place that under your left hand. But lift the right arm up, opening here, breathing here. Inhaling and exhaling. And then bring the right hand down. Roll onto the ball of the right foot, lift back into that lunge. Inhale, And exhale, take the hands down to the mat. Again, we find that flying pigeon. We're squeezing it in, pull the belly in. Very bird themed this morning on a Friday. Inhaling, exhaling, send it back. Find your plank, push back strong through your heels. Lower the knees if you want to. We bend the elbows tight to the ribs and we lower the chin and the chest towards the floor. Scoop up into our upward facing dog. And then take child's pose. Inhale. And exhale. Tuck the toes under, pull the belly in, and we take downward facing dog. Bring your feet together, bend the knees. Again, that little bunny hop. Can you bring your feet forward in between your hands? Lift up into that halfway lift, hands find your shins, flat back, look forwards. Exhale, take it down, and this time we step back long with our left leg. Pull the belly in. I'm just going to maneuver so you can see me. Inhaling and exhaling, we pull in, lift until we find that high lunge. Maybe bring your hands to prayer. Take the right hand now inside your right foot. Take the left heel down to the back. Push back strong through that left heel and send the left arm up to the sky. Opening here, inhaling. And exhaling. Inhale. And exhale. Bring the hand down. Roll onto the ball of the left foot again. Pull the belly in. Find that high lunge. Lift. Feel your quads engaged. Inhaling. Exhaling. Take the hands down. Flying pigeon. We squeeze that right leg in. Pull up. Lift. Send it to the back in your plank. Pull through the belly, keep a lovely flat back. Don't let your hips drop. Keep pushing back through the heels. Take the knees down if you want to, and we hover to the floor. Inhaling, we scoop into that upward facing dog. This time, exhale, down dog. Pat it through the heels. And then again, look at your hands. Bend your knees. And we bunny hop our feet forwards. Hang the forward fold. Let the hips be heavy, the head be long. Inhaling. And exhale. And then bend through the knees. And one last time, have a go at your crow. So you have crow where your elbows are inside the knees. If you feel you want to take it up a notch, you can come into crane, but please do watch my demo before you give it a go. And again, as always, disclaimer on Instagram, on Zoom, only take it at your own level. Don't ever put yourself at risk or harm. Listen to your body and just take it to the stage that you want to. Your palms are flat on the floor. You're bending through your knees, sinking the weight into your palms and taking the knees onto the backs of your triceps, lifting forward. And maybe you can play with lifting one foot, maybe lifting the other foot, or both of your feet up and off the floor. Squeeze those heels into the glutes. Hold for as long as you can. This could be in your crow or in your crane, whatever works for you. And then come into child's pose. Breathing here. Take the arms out in front of you, and one last little flow. We push back into down dog. Lift the right leg up, Bend the right knee, bring the right foot forward in between the hands. Find that high lunge, lifting. Sink the hands down, pull the belly in. And just see how low you can sink it this morning. Your legs should be nice and warm now. Firing yourself up for your Friday. Take the hands down to the floor and we find that flying pigeon. Hold, can you push up even more? 3, 2, 1, press it back to plank. Take the knees down if you want to and we hover down that chaturanga. Inhaling up dog, exhaling down dog. Last time, left leg lifts. Bend the left knee, bring the left foot forward in between the hands. Push back strong through the right heel. Pull into high lunge. Find that plank. Push back strong through the right heel. Big in breath. And out breath. Take the hands down to the floor. Flying pigeon one last time. Squeeze it in. You've got it. Nice. Take it back to plank. And lower the knees if you want, or we hover down. Inhaling up dog, exhaling a well-deserved child's pose. Take the forehead down, find the breath. Big deep inhale, and exhale. All the way back up. And just find a seated position on your mat. Nice. So, quads should be feeling nice and warm now. Can we send your left leg out and away from you? You want the sole of your right foot going into that left leg. Take your fingertips behind you, pull the belly in and open your chest. Big lift, big lengthen, roll the shoulders back and down. Inhale. And exhale. And then really simply, see if you can keep your fingers where they are. Can you change it over? You've got it. Lift, lengthen, open. And bring the soles of both of your feet together. Come onto your palms now rather than your fingertips behind you. Lift the chest. I'll demonstrate this way so that you can see. But you want to see if you can lift into like a kind of like a hammock. You're just being able to swing the hips. Push into your heels, trying to get even deeper and open the chest. It's quite strong in the adductors, the insides of those thighs. Bring it down. You may need to maneuver your feet a couple of inches further in front of you. And then we send the hands around the toes. Pull the chest in, trying to create that flat back rather than this rounding through the upper back. And we sink down to the floor. Let the head go to the mat, or as close to the mat as it can. Mine's hanging probably about a foot or so off the floor. And we lift up. We send our legs out and in front of us. We bend through the back of the knees, especially if your legs are pretty tight today. Hold on to your ankles and take the head down. Has anyone else found that they've become more of like an endurance walker or runner and their calves are now really tight? Go out once a day, finding that going for longer than we may normally do. So just be mindful of those tight calves. Stick with the breath and see if you can push your heels out and away from you. Lengthening into them, keep the back nice and flat or as flat as you can. It might just be a couple of centimeters that you move to lift up. And then bring yourself back. Take the fingers and the palms down to the floor, fingers pointing away. Lift your chest and just open here, taking it as far as you want to. Try not to maneuver your neck too much though, we're opening through the chest and the shoulders. Big deep inhale and exhale. And then bring your right foot in. Take the right foot flat to the floor. Lift yourself up, hug that knee in, and lift the leg up and off the mat. Take your right leg up and over the left thigh. Wrap the left arm around the right knee. Take the right hand behind, lift, open, breathe. Look over that right shoulder and find that twist. Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center. Walk that right foot over to the left side until it comes to the outside of the hip. We're folding forward over that right knee. Just be mindful again that you're not rounding through the back. And you might feel this in the back of your knee, the back of the calf, but just draw the head down towards the knee. Breathing here, find that breath. Slowly come up. We're going to extend that right leg out and away. Pull the left leg in. Lift the chest, pull the knee in towards us and take the left foot up and over the right thigh. Right arm wraps around that left knee. Left hand comes behind. Open the chest, pull the belly in. Look over that left shoulder. Take a big, deep inhale. And exhale. Big inhale and exhale. And then again, come back to center. Walk the left foot over to the right side. Stack the knees one on top of the other. Just be mindful, let the head come down to the floor, towards the floor. I say come down to the floor, unless you're very bendy, is going to be hovering off the mat for sure. Let the head maybe find the knee. And then gently come up. Send the left leg out and in front of you. And just one more time with the fingertips. Rather than pointing away this time, bring your fingertips in. Push the hands down in towards the floor. Lift your chest, roll your shoulders back and down and open it. An even stronger stretch through the shoulders. Just hold here for a moment, in and out. You may want to just stay here, especially if those shoulders are tight. If you want to take it one step further, our final pose today is tabletop but reverse table. So we're going to bring our feet in a little bit. Pull the belly in, lift your hips and send your hips up towards the sky. Opening really strong through the shoulders, engage those hamstrings, gently come down. Send your legs out and in front of you, release your arms and to counter pose, just let them hang heavy and over the legs. And then you roll all the way down to the floor. Just find your breath here. Take your right hand to your belly, your left hand to your chest. Breathe into your chest, then your belly, and let it go. Breathe it in. And let it go. Again, breathe in. And let it go. Breathe in. And let it go. One more big breath in. Filling that belly with air. And let it go.